Hello everyone, Magdalena here, Wolf of Coins. Thank you so much for tuning in. It has been ages, I know, but life is busy these days. I have two kids now and not enough sleep and not enough free time. But I'm excited to come back today with a new list of Slavic-themed novels for you to enjoy during long winter evenings. Last year I also made a video presenting you such books, and I will link it below so you can, if you haven't seen it, you can check it out. And during this year I've read a couple more and I will share them with you today. I will start with these three wonderful books. I'm sorry if there is if they are mirrored. I don't know. Before I could do videos without them being mirrored, but well, anyway, I will also put the list of the books in the video description so you can see the titles normally. But anyway, this is the Winternight Trilogy by Catherine Arden. And I mentioned this book, The Bear and the Nightingale, in my last year's video, because I was just after this first volume. And after that, I also read these two. And I must say, I loved them so, so much. It's amazing. It's awesome. I love it. I hope to come back to this series. Also, I read them at first as an ebook, and I loved them so much that I decided I will be coming back to these. So I want a paper version of them. So I've got them. This is this trilogy, and they take place in Russia in the old times, and it's full of fairy tales and interesting characters. It's simply magical. I loved it. I would also highly recommend that you read the Russian fairy tale about Morozko or Frost. It's a very short one, so it would give you more background for this. Well, it would be perfect if you just read a lot of Russian fairy tales, because you will find more of them here. But the main one would be the Morozko one. And Morozko is a character in this trilogy. So wonderful, wonderful trilogy. Next up, I read, this was a surprise for me, because this is one of my favorite authors ever, Patricia A. McKillip. She's an American writer, and yeah, she specializes in fantasy. But I didn't know that she wrote a book where we have some Slavic accents. There is a house on chicken legs. There is a firebird. These are not really like strong accents, but they are there. So if you enjoy like stories that are fairy tale like and a bit not non-linear, her books are awesome. So this one is very nice. And next up, oh my goodness, this one, this book is amazing, is a good word, but I don't know if it's enough. For me, this book was like, I couldn't breathe properly reading it. I was so delighted with every page. It's amazing. It is a retelling of another Russian fairy tale. And I also highly recommend you read it first. It's also not a long one, about Maria Morevna and Kasey the Deathless. I hope to write it somewhere. for you. Because then you can enjoy the story even more. I, of course, know a lot of Slavic fairy tales because I love to read them. So for me, this was incredible. But I suppose that even if you don't know them so well, this book will be amazing. It takes place in Russia, St. Petersburg / Leningrad, and fantasy realms also. So you get, for example, you get here fairy tale characters and communists at the same time. So it is an intense book, and I'm just so happy I could read it. It's wonderful. It has been translated into Polish, but it's out of print, which I didn't know, actually. I knew it was translated, but I just wanted to read the original, and then it turned out I wanted to recommend it to my friends in Poland, and it's like, oh, you cannot buy it. So that's a pity. But yeah, I bought this one for really not a high price. It's regular in print book. So, oh my goodness, just read it, simply. Then I have this for you. This is a Polish edition because I read it with my son, but the original is, oh yeah, did I say it's Deathless by Catherine and Valente, not sure how to pronounce, but I know her other books, the duology of the Orphan's Tales. It was so amazing. So I really wanted to give this a try, and I'm so happy I did. So The House with Chicken Legs by Sophie Anderson. This is a Polish edition, and it's very pretty. It's a pity it's mirrored, or if it's not mirrored, then you're having fun right now that I think it's being mirrored, because maybe I could turn it in my program. But anyway, it's really nice, and you can read this with your kids. So the story is inspired by the Baba Yaga's hut. Of course, Baba Yaga appears also in this one. She appears in the... Which one? One of the Winternight trilogy. Probably in this one. And some kind of Baba Yaga appears here, because Baba Yaga is all the fun these days. She's very popular in Poland. It's been a boom this year, really. But getting back to this book, it's about a Baba Yaga who lives with her granddaughter in a house that has legs. So this is an interesting interpretation. It's not really like based on any specific fairy tale, but this is just an interesting look at the idea of the house on chicken feet, and as opposed to traditional Slavic fairy tale version of the house, which has legs. But it doesn't walk around on these legs. Normally, it just turns around and around and around. In Polish tradition, it even has only one leg. So it turns on this one leg. But anyway, here the house moves and it goes to various places. And it's interesting. And as I said, you can read this with your kids. This you cannot read with your kids. I don't recommend for this for kids. And lastly, this one. You might have heard this name, Olga Tokarczuk. She got Nobel Prize for 2018 in literature. And this one is, it's called, in Polish, it's Prawiek I inne czasy. I think in English it's something like Primeval and Other Times. It will be linked, it will be written in the description box. But this one, I I've been wanting to read this one for a while now, but it was out of print. And then, boom, she got the Nobel Prize and everything is being republished. So this one has also been translated into English. That's why I'm showing this. And again, this is not based on a specific fairy tale. And it's... at first glance, it's not really Slavic. It is taking place in a fictionary village in Poland. But if you look a bit deeper, you find motifs. You find familiar things from Slavic traditions. And in any case, this is an amazing book. It's not a traditional novel with where the plot goes linear. It's more like a fragmentary story of lives of people from this village of Pravik or Primeval, you just get immersed in their lives, and there is this strange reality, but also this very realistic reality mixed together. And there is also Baba Yaga style character there. She's not called that, but you can recognize her, and other motifs as well. And this one is also I read both Deathless and Pravik in November, and I was like, okay, now I need some light reading, because it's been amazing, but I just need to catch a breath. Normally one book like this or this would be enough for 1 month for me, because I'm really processing the emotions. And also, trigger warning, this is definitely not for kids. There are war things. This is Poland from 1914 till 1994. So you have two wars and the horrors of wars in there. So just so you know, but it's just a very, very good book. So this is what I got for you today. Please let me know if you've enjoyed. Maybe you know some other books that I could check out. And they can be both in English or Polish. So please let me know. And have a lovely day. Bye.